Good morning, everyone. Tina Spaulding, Trance Channel here for our daily Course in Miracles lesson together. Thank you for joining us today. Today we are doing lesson number 109, I Rest in God. We ask for rest today and quietness, unshaken by the world's appearances. We ask for peace and stillness in the midst of all the turmoil born of clashing dreams. We ask for safety and for happiness, although we seem to look on danger and on sorrow, and we have the thought that will answer our asking with what we request. I rest in God. This thought will bring you to the rest and quiet, peace and stillness, and the safety and the happiness you seek. I rest in God. This thought has power to wake the sleeping truth in you, whose vision sees beyond appearances, so that same truth in everyone and everything there is. Here is the end of suffering for all the world and anyone, everyone who ever came and yet will come to linger for a while. Here is the thought in which the Son of God is born again to recognize himself. I rest in God, completely undismayed. This thought will carry you through the storms and strife, past misery and pain, past loss and death, and onward to the certainty of God. There is no suffering it cannot heal. There is no problem that it cannot solve, and no appearance but will turn to truth before the eyes of you who rest in God. This is the day of peace. You rest in God, and while the world is torn by winds of hate, your rest remains completely undisturbed. Yours is the rest of truth. Appearances cannot intrude on you. You call to all to join you in your rest, and they will hear and come to you because you rest in God. They will not hear another voice than yours because you gave your voice to God, and now you rest in him and let him speak through you. In him you have no cares and no concerns, no burdens, no anxiety, no pain, no fear of future, and no past regrets. In timelessness you rest while time goes by without its touch upon you, for your rest can never change in any way at all. You rest today, and as you close your eyes, sink into stillness. Let these periods of rest and respite reassure your mind that all its frantic fantasies were but the dreams of fever that has passed away. Let it be still and thankfully accept its healing. No more fearful dreams will come now that you rest in God. Take time today to slip away from dreams and into peace. Each hour that you take your rest today, a tired mind is suddenly made glad. A bird with broken wings begins to sing. A stream, long dry, begins to flow again. The world is born again each time you rest, and hourly remember that you came to bring the peace of God into the world, that it might take its rest along with you. With each 5 minutes that you rest today, the world is near awaking, and the time when rest will be the only thing there is comes closer to all worn and tired minds, too weary now to go their way alone. And they will hear the bird begin to sing and see the stream begin to flow again with hope reborn and energy restored to walk with lightened steps along the road that suddenly seems easy as they go. You rest within the peace of God today and call upon your brothers from your rest to draw them to their rest along with you. You will be faithful to your trust today, forgetting no one, bringing everyone into the boundless circle of your peace. The holy sanctuary where you rest, open the temple doors and let them come from far across the world and near as well. Your distant brothers and your closest friends, bid them all enter here and rest with you. You rest within the peace of God today, quiet and unafraid. Each brother comes to take his rest and offer it to you. We rest together here, for thus our rest is made complete, and what we give today we have received already. Time is not the guardian of what we give today. We give to those unborn and those passed by, to every thought of God, and to the mind in which these thoughts were born and where they rest. And we remind them of their resting place each time we tell ourselves, I rest in God. So that is our lesson today, lesson number 109, I rest in God. Let's see what Jesus has to say today. You are blessed beings indeed. I am that one that you know as Jesus, and I rest in God. And oh, what a joy it is. What a joy it is not to be pushed and pulled by the tiny and incessant nagging and fears and judgments of the world. Take some time today, dear ones, to stop and be quiet with yourself and rest in God, knowing that all is well in the world. The ego mind will argue and say, I cannot rest. I have too much to do. I have children. I have a job. I have a mortgage. I have bills and dishes. I have so much to do. Even in that life, with so many obligations, so many responsibilities, you can sit in your car in the parking lot for 5 minutes and rest in God. Stop thinking, stop judging, stop fearing and stop worrying, and just be. And you will see a difference in your world. If you do that for 5 minutes each hour, you will see at the end of the day that you have transformed yourself. Each hour that follows that 5 minutes, you will find that you are less anxious, that you are less worried, that you are less controlling or fearful or bullying, because you are reinforcing the truth that you can rest in God. The ego's stories convince you that there is no place for rest. And you have a phrase in your society, the devil loves idle hands. That is because that teaching, the devil loves idle hands, is to prevent you from stopping so that you will discover that you can rest in God. The idea of the Sabbath is a more positive reflection of that, the idea that you can rest for a day and the world will still continue. And that is the truth. If you take 5 minutes out of every hour, you will see that everything keeps going. You are not that important. You are not the thing that is driving this world. There is an energy that is playing itself out. The collective manifestations of everybody's beliefs, thoughts, and ideas is going to keep bringing things your way. But as you decide to tune in, tap in to that source energy, that is where you come from, you will be energized in a different way. You will be getting your energy not from the horizontal ego world, what you can get, the material possessions, the prestige. You will not be getting your power from there. You will be getting your power from where true power comes, which is your connection to the divine. And you will see it play out in a different day. I am that one that you know as Jesus. I rest in God, and I suggest you do too. We will see you again tomorrow. Thank you for joining us. Bye.